That also triggered a question for you, Natasha, because in the early episode that we had last week, you've talked about how you were kicked out of your home, you were by yourself. What advice you would give to parents of teenagers who would find themselves in that situation? How we as parents can be better listeners, and also we can stand by you, because you know what? True, that's not what we would like for you, because all of us parents have dreams for our children, how we want things to be better for them than they were for ourselves. But once we find ourselves in that predicament, how do we go about helping you? How can we be more open to make you feel that you can come to us, that we can help you? Because I know, God forbid, if that would happen to my daughter, I would want to be there for her. I want her to know that I will always be there. Mm-hmm. So how do I make that much easier for her? Like, and also to excuse Alex's embarrassment, and also so that that future child who's going to come on, regardless if she wants to keep her or give her up for adoption, how do I help her to that process myself?
It's a hard topic to talk about for me, mainly because my parents, you know, they did kick me out upon finding out that I was deciding to keep my child. Mm-hmm. My advice to parents, you know, your child is pregnant. This child is still your child. You know, you can't just let go of the child and say, you know, now it's your problem. Mm-hmm. Yes, you know, it's hard for a parent to look and see that, you know, they're, you know, 13, 14, 15, or whatever age they are pregnant, and they had so many dreams and so many things that they want to see their child do, and automatically they assume that this pregnancy is going to ruin their life, and mm-hmm. that, in fact, is not true. I think parents, if they are more involved and more positive in their child's life, they can actually help, they can help the teen make a better decision for her own life. And it goes for the fathers too. I feel like there's a lot of parents who don't put enough emphasis on the teen fathers who have, mm-hmm. you know, fathered the children. It affects both parents. It's not just the mother. Mm-hmm. But mainly, I do think that parents should just be open and talk more without the fighting, without the arguing. Because at this point, you know, your daughter's pregnant, and you have to figure out what's going to go on from here on out. It's, you know, talking about how it happened and why it happened is something that I feel like can wait a little bit. You know, it's crucial during the beginning of the pregnancy to just make sure she's getting the right care, and, you know, decide, you know, are you going to do, you know, there's abortion, there's adoption, you can choose to parent. There's just way too much to talk about for you to shut your child out like that.